All right, so we're on the draw with this pretty mediocre hand. With any land, we can play a Shrieker and a Tar Snare. I suppose we must keep this. Though I will say this is a very middling type hand. Hoping our opponent doesn't have a really quick deck. Okay. We are quite likely to draw a land by turn 3, so that part's good. Oh, no. All right. If it's not going to be a land, at least it can be something that can trade with this Castigator here. Nope. Devouring Flames kills it immediately. All right, well, we just need to see a land or a something. All right. Going to be one of those games? All right, there we go. I'm just going to kill this thing. Normally, I just play the Shrieker and try to trade it off, but it's just too risky. If our opponent has another pump spell or a trick or something, then we're just in big trouble. Gonna need to find that green mana, though. If we do, I like our chances, actually, because my opponent's running out of spells pretty quickly here. And we're dead. Yeah, drawing a green card there is just death. Can't cast anything. Taking 6 here. And that's game. I should probably just concede here. Yeah, I don't even want to show my opponent what else I'm up to here. Well, that sucked. Let's see if we've got anything to do here. We want to kind of go shields up here for sure. A giant mantis wouldn't be terrible. Maybe we trade it out for a Myers Malice. You know, a card that doesn't affect the board right away. Myers Malice isn't terrible either, though. We've got a lot of creatures, so I'm not super worried about that. Maybe for one of the huge fatties, maybe for a Breaker. How about that? All right, because if we get a Bane of Balaghed down, it's going to be game anyway. All right, we're going to go first here. And yes, we will keep this hand. This is similar to the other, except for much better, because we can actually, with any land, we can just cast basically our hand outside of this Mina and Den. Vampire Envoy should be very good against this opponent as well. Okay. Play an Envoy, probably block something, probably have it die. And then eventually get it back. This could be really annoying. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll just pass here. No colorless mana yet for our opponent, so we're likely to not have to take damage here. All right, 2 of our 3 red cards in hand isn't great. All right, let's attack here. Gain, just to gain a life. Oh, we even got in for a damage. I like that. So this thing can prevent us from blocking at all. All right, Spark Mage's Gambit to get in for some damage. I respect it. I think we're probably going to end up just racing here. So let's just do that. Remember, we're the ones with the pulse, so if anything dies in combat here, we get to just swing this race math vastly back in our favor. Plus, an embodiment really does mess with combat, just in the sense that it represents so much extra damage. That's a little bit annoying. Just because it's exiled, but oh well. All right, let's just ship the team here. I'm just going to follow up with this Night Watch. It's going to kill the bigger creature. Now the attacking envoy gives the Clostridium Night Watch flying. That is not going to do it. That's really sweet. Chumping there. I could do 7, bring you to 2. Doesn't change anything anyway. Go ahead. Is that lethal? No way. 5, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I've also got pulse. Ah. 13, 14, 15. Yeah, we still win, though. Would have been Xaxes, though. So press into service. We'll have to keep that in mind as well in the future. Wow. Yeah, this is tough. This is where I want a Meyer's Malice in my deck, you know? That's actually quite good for that scenario. Opponents trying to hold combat tricks or removal spells or those type of, you know, steal your guy effects. They can be really good. All right. Well, this is a slugfest, so let's just hope that we slug harder here on the last one. Ugh. Man, this hand really needs some action, but it's so good if it finds it. I am going to keep it. Because if we find 2s and 3s, like Boulder Salvo killing creatures is insane. Oh, that's pretty good. Yeah, that's really good, actually. That'll likely keep our opponent's first threat at bay. All right, 2 spells is exactly what we wanted to see here, so this is coming together. And we're just going to snap that thing off with Tar Snare here. I think I want to get this Crumbling Vestige down. We've already got red, so it doesn't change anything as far as colors go. We'll just kill that thing and then play a Warden. Yeah, opponent's deck is sweet. Play a Warden and then we'll see what happens here, but next turn it could definitely be the case that we want to go pulse Boulder Salvo. Depending on what our board state looks like. Ooh. A Bane. Oh, actually, we'd have to pulse back our opponent's card here. No, that's maybe not so good. All right, then if that's the case, let's just kill this thing. Attack. Pass the turn back. And this could get risky, but I think we do want to run out of Bane of Ball of Ged next turn if we can. We'll have to make sure that we don't just immediately lose to press, but. And kill my guy too. Yeah, all right. Well, that probably isn't going to be the case then. I'm just going to play a Baloth Knoll. Or am I? If I play Baloth Knoll and my opponent has land, which they do, right? They just returned one. Yes, kept the planes in hand so that they can trigger slide runner. So we're dead to, no matter what we play here, we're dead to, well, no, actually that's not true. So if I play Orin Reef Invoker and pass, and my opponent steals Orin Reef Invoker and plays a land, steals Orin Reef Invoker, that's 3, 6, 9, 10, 11, that's 13 damage I can pulse to get out of it, but then realistically we're dead the next turn anyway. So that's not going to work. If my opponent does not have press, would I rather just have the Baloth Knoll down? I take 6 damage, go to 3, but then get to untap and play Pulse to go to 9. It's probably better just to play the Invoker here. This also gets us full value for our Knoll, potentially. Although unlikely, as we're probably just going to Pulse anyway. Okay, so we're forced to pulse here. Probably still just going to die, though. Yeah, this is just rough. Opponent's deck is hyper-aggressive and very good. Yeah. We lose. So that's how it goes sometimes. Tough matchup there for us, and good draws from our opponent. We had some reasonable draws there ourselves. I mean, we fired off a Pulse of Marasa and still just got completely smashed that game. And it wasn't really that close. So yeah, tough one for the round one loss, but hey, it does happen. Happens to all of us. If you want to find me on social media, Marshall_LR. And if you want to find the show, you can do it on lrcast.com or right here on Channel Fireball. We'll see you next time.